第二十三队表演题目是 Let Education Talk， 计时开始。
Hey, honey, what time is it? Is it 7 already?
Yeah, Auntie is coming back from the math class in 5 minutes. I'll make omelette. That's her favorite.
Mommy, Daddy, I got 100 on the math test again.
Great job, my darling.
And I got accepted to Princeton University. I'm going to study in America.
I'm so proud of you, my dear daughter.
Auntie, promise me you'll take good care of yourself, okay?
Mommy, I promise you, don't worry, okay? You take good care of yourself too. Love you.
We will. Don't forget to call us. Take care.
Bye.
Hey, look at the hot chick.
Is she the new teacher? Let me greet her. Yo, sis.
Got a boyfriend?
Why are you wasting your life on we hopeless losers?
Don't you get a life?
Why do you call yourself like that? I'm here to help. Please don't give up on yourself, okay?
Did you hear that?
Oh, what a sand.
Stop preaching. We don't need your pity.
I don't understand. I've been working so hard. I always believe in hard work brings success. All these medals prove it, don't they? But why doesn't it work this time? All my efforts seem useless.
Ma'am, I wonder if you can teach me how to solve this math problem.
Certainly. As long as you really want to learn, I'll try my best to teach you.
Are you okay? Well, actually, I think you're the coolest teacher I've ever met in the prison. So, cheer up.
Thanks for telling me that. I'm flattered. In fact, you teach me much, much more. I truly hope you can find a meaning of your life.
After the big earthquake, few people were willing to come to Haiti to help us.
But you came as an angel to guard me and guide me.
I'm so touched.
Listening to your story, I found the world much bigger than I used to think.
Auntie, I really love your book. You're leaving next week.
Mary, I have to go back to work in New York. But promise me, always believe in yourself, okay?
I certainly will. Auntie, you really changed my life.
Auntie? Auntie?
Yes, ma'am.
Auntie, great job. And good news,
you are going to be promoted.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
I should be delighted, but I don't feel like I am. I just can't concentrate on the work after coming back from Haiti. I can't forget the naive faces on those children. What should I do now? Maybe I should call my parents.
Hello?
Mom, Dad, it's me. I'm confused.
Why? What's going on?
I don't see my value in what I'm doing now.
What do you mean? Is there something wrong with your work?
Not really. My boss is pretty satisfied with my performances. But I don't think this is my calling.
What do you have in mind then?
After visiting so many places around the world, seeing people in need, I started thinking about Taiwan.
Taiwan? I don't see any problems here.
In the urban areas, there are enough resources. However, there are still children in remote places need equal chances to see the world.
You do know this is an adventurous move, don't you? You might lose your dream job in America for good.
I'm aware of that, but I just want to see where this expedition would take me.
All right, if this is what you truly want, you have all the support from me and your dad.
Thank you, Mom and Dad.
Auntie, you're back!
miss you so much.
So, Anting, what's your next plan?
I want to fund an NGO to help those children in need, and it's called TFT, Teach for Taiwan.
Good girl, we're really proud of you.
Do you love adventures? If you do, please come and join Teach for Taiwan.
Be brave to dream on. Thank you.
第二十四对表演题目是 Out of this world, 计时开始。
We open on the daily scenes at Galaxy High. Here, we have Blurb. Blurb is a universe exchange student. She just studied to attend Galaxy High. And you will see, she has a lot to learn about Earth culture.
Hey Blurb, guess what? I just aced my math test. Integers! Ha! More like in the bag. What's going on with you?
Wow, congrats, Thomas. Well, nothing much on my end. Just waiting for a lunch line to start moving. You know, these three stomachs aren't gonna fill themselves.
Hey, what room are going? Captured!
Whoa, smart alert. Sorry for bumping into you, but you need to watch your tone.
I want to watch you go back to your country.
Oh yeah? Well, we were here first. Maybe you should go back to your country.
Oh no. Hey Burp, can you give me a hand with these two?
Sure.
Ooh.
Come on you guys, knock it off. I know you are not from the same country, but do you need to bicker and argue and fight all the time?
I think we should stand between these two to avoid the lunchroom brawl.
Wow, that's always fun.
What was that all about?
Well, there was an industrial boom 20 years ago. The popularity of smartphones and computers drove a lot of business from Pentopia. Neymar's grandfather lost his job during the shift. I think Neymar's family still holds some resentment over that.
Oh, with Neymar from Pentopia and Snoopy from Technia. I can see how the problem between these two.
I can't stand those lazy Pentopians. The people there are so slothful. They pick an apple, take a nap, pick an apple, take a nap, all day. Can they see that without hard work and drive, their people will only be a burden on the world?
Dirty Technians everywhere. Their factories are so bad for the environment. They think they are so great, but all they are doing is making a mess of everything. I'm glad my country does things in a natural way. It may be slower, but it's a lot cleaner for the planet.
This is more of a culture versus culture, and less of a Snoopy versus Mena. Wow, this was an interesting school day.
I agree. PE class was intense.
I mean with Snoopy and Neymar. What do you know about racism?
I read a bunch of books before coming here. I read that racism and cultural indifference are a big issue on this planet.
That's true. Did your book have any explanation as to why?
They mentioned past events and misconception.
That's what I have come across too. I think Snoopy and Neymar have been based on misconception.
You say they are good people when they are alone, right? So how can we get them to see that?
Let me think. They used to be friends back in elementary school. Then they went to different junior high school. After that, things were never the same.
Hey, there they are!
Hey guys, how's it going?
Pretty good, except I have to stand next to her. I'll just focus on my music.
Things are okay. Just waiting for the bus listening to my music.
Oh, really? What are you guys listening to?
Sugar Bye.
Maroon 5? Oh, you like Maroon 5?
Oh, wait, you like Maroon 5?
Yes, I love all of his songs.
Oh my gosh, Anna is so cheery!
Yes.
I guess we are not so different after all.
Yeah, all this time, I didn't like you because of what my family told me about Technians.
Ouch, same here. I didn't like you because of what my family told me about Pentopians.
Yeah, I guess we can never really judge a book by its cover. So far, I'm liking your first chapter.
Yeah, I guess you shouldn't make judgments on people or even an entire culture based on what you hear. We should give everyone a fair chance to prove their worth.
before immediately labeling them as worthless or no good.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. You might have more in common than you could imagine. You know, Maroon 5 is cool and all, but you wanna know who my favorite singer is? He's so hot and I just love his hair.
What? You know me?
Zin!
Yeah, I love all of his songs. One day he's gonna be my boyfriend.
Sorry, Neymar. He's gonna be my boyfriend.
Mine!
Mine! Hey! Hey!
Here we go again.
Bob,
thank you.
The 25th performance theme is International Exchange. 计时开始。
Look, look at the commercials on the television.
What are the commercials talking about?
The commercials talk about supplementary artery of traveling and having a special friend into Santa Barbara. The event is funded and organized by the government.
See ya, Regeneration dies only today. Go, hurry up, we sign up and go to play in Santa Barbara.
Have you heard of anything? It seems like that your cell phone is ringing. There is a phone call.
Right? Blah, 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 blah. That's what? It is a good news. Make you excited.
We are lucky people. I am excited and stimulated, aren't you?
Of course, why not? We should tidy up our luggage.And go to Salvador to do sightseeing.
Let's go! Wow, is this their airport? The airport is simple covered with the simple materials.
Here, we instantly travel this common west and have a nice vacation.
We could have two people look at a map and we rent a vehicle that makes schedule more convenient.
I can't find a wheel machine rental shop. And what do we do now?
Oh, excuse me, I was concentrating on where to find a car rental.
It doesn't matter. Where come from? I can help you.
Can you take us to a car rental? And we would like to rent a car that's travel around this beautiful country.
Okay, my pleasure. We can be your guide and take you around of our hometown.
I live here for a long time, so we know the geographical, environment, and the roads.
Here we go! Let's have fun to the journey!
Characteristic is heaven's ear report for a long time.
And how about our lunch?
I think we can come to our house and I cook the local food for you to eat.
Brilliant! So, very good opinion!
Our food are not very good because our country's poor soil makes crops unable to grow up.
How can we do that? We can deal with these problems.
If you need us to settle these problems, we can do our best to assist you.
Agree with those! Many people solve this problem. It's a simple matter.
This issue is a piece of cake.
This trouble was finally solved for a total of 2 days in this cultivation of traps above.
so it isn't pumping, but the government pick you to Salvador?
That's what we are scared of, this mishap in agricultural technology.
The first problem is the soil is barren, second is lack of water.
So we divide ourselves into two groups, a group to find some water and another group find some materials.
That group A, and we go to find water.
Let's start as soon as possible.
That's a good opinion. Thank you for supporting us. Thank you very much, Nanawi. How to repay you?
We add people for happiness. We get along very well, don't you?
Thank you for your hospitality and enthusiasm. And we have to return to my hometown, a little miss.
Thank you for
watching and listening.
The 26th 表演题目是 Understanding Parent-Children Interactions Through Homestay. 计时开始.
Mom, I'm joining the school soccer team today.
What? Soccer team?
Yeah, soccer team. Isn't that cool?
Hold on, young man. How about your schoolwork? You were only second in your class. Doesn't that bother you?
Why would it? You want to fake my schoolwork? We practice on Saturdays.
Saturdays?
I'm home.
Honey, you know what? James joined the soccer team and will practice on Saturdays.
What?
Why can't I practice soccer?
Your score is way more important than anything.
Right, score determines your future. Any questions?
What?
No questions.
All right.
A few weeks later, James was suggested to go to the U.S. for exchange student. James also wanted to experience American family culture through his homestay. In James' homestay, he got to know Kelly, a daughter of his host parents. They often play soccer together.
We are home!
Hey kids, how's school?
Very good, we won a soccer game!
Yeah!
Did you both score?
Yes, we did!
Kelly and I each score 4 points.
You rock!
Shh! Hold on to my mom. Hi, Mom.
How's the U.S.?
It's cool.
Okay, it's good to know you're okay. Bye.
Hey, James. You seem not to be very close to your mother.
We normally don't communicate well. She only cares about my grades.
Grades?
Before coming here, I argued with my mom because I wanted to join the soccer team.
Why?
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 Because I was only second in my class.
Well, Kelly doesn't always pass her test, but we don't fight about it. Right, Kelly?
Yes.
Nobody is perfect and can always get perfect scores. We care more about her being happy and trying her best.
Besides, we talk about our days while we eat.
One time, I told Kelly about a good way for parents and children to get closer, the acronym TABLE. Each letter has a special meaning.
T is talk for togetherness.
A is accept for affirmation.
B is build for blessing.
L is listen for love.
And E is enjoy for example.
Wow, I've never heard of that before. But it sounds like a better way to interact.
You know, even though I get fed up with my parents when they make decisions for me, I know they do it because they love me.
I never thought of that before. I feel guilty now.
James returned to Taiwan and led his life as usual. He joined the school soccer team even though his parents didn't agree.
I'm home!
Hey, sweetie, how's school?
Very good. I've learned a lot, and when I play soccer, I...
Hold up! I told you not to play soccer. Why don't you listen?
Mom, actually, I'm trying hard to be first in the class. I play soccer only after finishing my homework. Other than studying, I need some time to take a rest.
so that I can have more energy to study. Isn't it true, Mommy?
Well, sounds reasonable, but...
I'm home.
Mommy, dinner is ready. Come and eat.
Oh.
Dad, can we have a chat for a bit?
Son, we just want you to be rich and successful, that's all.
And what if I'm rich but unhappy and unhealthy? I also care about my hobbies.
What are you talking about? You...
Mom, Dad, nobody's perfect. Even so, I try to meet your expectation because I want you to be happy. You love me, so you want me to focus on my study. But playing soccer will make me much healthier. So please, look.
How do you think, Paul?
I don't know.
My host father once described how they interact with each other. They talk for togetherness. So this time I brought you both into the discussion. They accept for affirmation, so my eager to get your affirmation of my decision. They build for blessing, and I really want to hear your blessing of my soccer life. They listen for love, and I did find your love through your request. They enjoy for example, so now let me share more soccer playing stories with you.
Wow, James, you talk differently.
You seem more mature, son.
Wait. Right now, one thing's way more important.
What?
Dinner has been ready long enough. Let's go eat together.
Okay, let's start.
T A
B
L
E.
Thank you, everybody.
第二十七队表演题目是 One Day Taipei， 计时开始。
Lucas is a student from America. He's going to visit Taiwan for a week. Today, Aaron, Casey, and Elaine are responsible for picking Lucas up from the airport.
Hey, excuse me. Are you Lucas?
Yes, I am.
Hey, Lucas. Nice to meet you. I'm Aaron. Welcome to Taiwan.
Nice to meet you too. I'm Lucas.
I'm Elaine.
It is really nice to see you here. I was worried that I will get lost after getting off the plane. Fortunately, there are you guys.
Don't worry, we're all here now.
Yes, we'll take you to some attractions that we want to go.
Where do you want to go?
Maybe Rauho Night Market will be a good choice. I want to taste some Taiwanese local cuisine.
No problem, let's not waste time. Let's go there right now.
Let's go.
At Rauho Night Market.
This is so special. We don't have any market like here in our country.
Okay, let us show you Taiwanese local cuisine.
Hey, Lucas.
What's this?
This is stinky tofu. It's a form of fermented tofu that has a strong odor. You can taste it.
It smells disgusting, but tastes delicious.
Hey, Lucas.
What's this?
It's pig blockhead. Pig blockhead is made with pork blood, sinking rice, and soy broth. It's fried or steamed and coated in peanut flour.
Do you like it?
It is a very special food that I have never seen before.
Oh, it's time to go back. How do you feel today?
It was a really wonderful day. I've learned many things about Taiwan, like Taiwanese famous attractions and Taiwanese local cuisine. And it was a pleasure to know you all. Tonight, I will be able to sleep well.
Yes, we're happy too. See you tomorrow.
At Jofen Street. Jofen Street is one of Taiwan's most popular tourist attractions, including a lot of local cuisine. For example, Torobos. Jofen Street is famous because Japan's most popular animation, Spirited Away, has framed this view in the movie. It also attracted a lot of Japanese and Korean tourists to visit here.
Wow, Spirited Away is one of my favorite animations. I didn't expect it's from here. What's this?
It's terrible. The specialty in Japan is terrible. There are other kinds of flavor: sweet potato, green tea, yam, and sesame. The decoration of the interior house still maintains the Japanese style.
Wow! What a special taste! It is really nice.
And there is also a well-known attraction, Shopping Theater. It's Taiwan's first theater. It was very popular in early Taiwan. Now it has been converted into a tourist attraction. There are many movie posters and shooting tours for early Taiwan. It's worth a visit.
I think it is very cool and historical. And when visiting, I can feel excitement and the human touch of the early Taiwanese society.
Now, let's take you to a place where you can show the history of early Taiwan, Sun Yat-sen Memorial Hall. At Sun Yat-sen Memorial Hall. In 1964, after the Second World War, in order to remember Sun Yat-sen, the government began to build the Sun Yat-sen Memorial Hall.
And Sun Yat-sen Memorial Hall is adjacent to Taipei 101 and Xinyi Commercial Center. The auditorium of the Sun Yat-sen Memorial Hall is the largest state-level performance in Taiwan. It's important for art and cultural activities.
I really like this place because I can feel the citizens respecting their country. And I should pay more attention to my own country's culture and history.
We still have time. Do you have other places you want to go?
Maybe Taipei 101 will be a good choice. I heard it was used to be the world's tallest building.
Thank you.
The 28队 表演 题目 是 Waste of the Globe, Chances of the Road. 计时开始.
Hey, how did you like Mother United Nations you attended yesterday?
It was really an eye-opener.
How so?
There, I found so many like-minded people who are interested in the international affairs.
It seems that Mother United Nations is very interesting. Come in next time.
Welcome aboard. You won't regret it.
Back to business. What's the requirement or assignment?
Develop devices to solve a global problem.
We're computer science major, not sociologist. I don't see the connection.
I'm just as clueless as you. Hey, Mom, the dish smells heavily.
Whoa,
hands off the food. These dishes are for our special guest.
For me? How kind of you, Mrs. Johnson.
Sorry, honey, I love you, but those are for Lucy. But you're welcome to stay for lunch.
You're the best, Mrs. Johnson. But Lucy? Now I remember, the couch surfing host was Charlene Davis then.
Yep, but this time she's our couch surfing guest. It's truly admirable the way she volunteered by going couch surfing.
Is anybody home?
Speak of the devil!
Hi!
How dirty my friend has been so long!
You haven't changed at all!
Oh, thank you!
Lucy, this is my mom.
Thank you.
And this is my friend, hello. Tina. She's here for our assignment.
Make yourself at home, Lucy. And I guess you girls have a lot of catching up to do, so I'll just leave you alone. Oh, thank you.
Welcome to Taiwan!
Hi!
I've heard a lot about you.
Really? You know what? I was the delegate of Spain in the Mother United Nations yesterday!
What a coincidence!
Lunch time!
Yes!
My mom is the best cook.
I've been looking for her for lunch.
Excuse me, I have to take this coat. Take your time, Mom. Hey guys, I'm starving! Let's dig in!
Yes!
Tina, sweetie, can you give me the hand in the kitchen?
Sure, Mrs. Johnson!
So, how did your Mother United Nations conference go yesterday?
It was incredible! I represent Spain and exchange opinions on the problem of food and hunger with other delegates!
Oh, so you did have a great time, right?
With no public speaking,
and little knowledge of the world culture. The first try in the conference was a disaster for me.
I feel so sorry for you. Did you get over it?
More so. I won the best delegate award.
Wow, it's a big step.
Exactly. Thanks to Model United Nations, I know more about the world and myself.
You bet. Mrs. Johnson is the best cook. I have so much in the kitchen and I feel pumping full. I'm about to burst.
Me too. I guess you have enough of it.
Wait! Are you going to throw out the food that is still fresh?
It's wasteful. Foods are for bellies, not for bins.
You're right. When I was preparing for the Model United Nations, I was shocked to learn that 11% of the population don't have enough to eat.
But meanwhile, a lot of food never gets eaten.
I was so sorry for my reckless behavior.
You should be.
I wish to find a way to redistribute the food to those who really need it.
Let me think about it.
This is it!
What is it?
Our assignment! We can devise an app which helps plan and distribute excess food.
I got it! We can visit different countries and set up soup kitchen. We can turn waste food into meals to help those who really need it.
It's a brilliant idea, but you're there that I can afford the flight tickets, hotels, and other expenses.
Aww. I know. Go couch surfing like me. Couch surfing saves the cost of accommodation.
Plus, we can find sponsors. I know the project name, One Journey, One Mission. It sponsors Taiwanese who set their hearts on making a difference to the world.
Coming! I have a long desire to enhance my global vision.
I'm so moved. You youngsters are truly the future of the world. I hope I'm not too old to join you and broaden my view too.
Of course not!
But Mom, what contribution will you make?
Devise an app? Of course!
Mrs. Johnson, I didn't know that you're a computer geek!
Oh, silly, I was just kidding. As an experienced housewife, I'm expert in cooking. At this, I can help cook.
Then, what are we waiting for? Let's get started and work on our app.
Yay!
Bow.
Thanks for your attention.
The 29th Dorothy, Toto and Friends Help Build Global Vision. 计时开始。啦啦啦啦啦！
哦，丑的 ！How I dream to leave a small mountain town and get out to experience the real and its diverse cultures.
I know how you're feeling, Dorothy. Maybe in our future, we will see all that is outside our small mountain town. We can meet other teams and exchange ideas on how to improve the global outlook of our planet.
Yeah, those will be great experiences for us and our new friends from abroad. But right now, a typhoon is coming! We have to go home now! She looks so sad. Say, young lady, what's your name?
Hello there. I'm Scarecrow Angela. I'm here hoping that my town will open up a school for my friends and I. We really want to learn all we can. Sometimes I feel like I don't even have a brain. Who are you?
Well, I'm Toto, and this is Dorothy. We are sorry to hear you don't have the chance to go to school.
It's okay.
Why don't you come with us back to Taiwan, where we can show you how a good educational system works?
Yes, Toto, this is a great idea. I believe that we can provide Angela with a vision on how to improve her country's educational system.
Wow, do you really think so? That would be wonderful. What are we waiting for?
Let's go!
Hey there! You guys, over here! Yeah, you three!
Me?
I've been listening to your conversation, and I'm hoping you could help me out too. You see, I'm stuck here, rusted, from all the terrible weather we had due to climate change that is affecting my country.
Oh my, that's terrible!
Let us help you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, how long have you been like this?
Oh, I can't really remember. We've been having the craziest weather here for the last 30 or so years. What do you guys think we can do about this?
Well, Dorothy and Toto say that Taiwan can help my country improve our educational system. So, maybe they have an idea on how to do something about climate change. What do you two think?
Dear man, I'm sure that if you come with us to Taiwan, we can offer ideas to help you. And we'd love to hear your ideas on ways you feel we can improve certain aspects of our country.
That's awesome! We could start a youth exchange program where we share ideas on building a better world for the future!
Yes! And we don't have to limit our exchange to just education and climate change. We could also include other important topics, such as community development, where we exchange ideas on how to assist the poor and needy.
Absolutely. And don't forget about conservation issues, such as protecting and saving the earth resources.
Yes, I think we got some great ideas, everyone. Now, let's step into the classroom.
To help Angela and the students in her country, we could build more schools, start a countrywide teacher training program,
seek donations for textbooks and school supplies, find second-hand computers for us to learn with.
Yeah, those are some great ideas. Now, how about CMAP and the world's need to help climate change? What can we do?
Well, here are a few ideas. Use more renewable power. Cut back on landfill waste and recycle all you can.
Establish carbon taxes, forcing polluters to pay a high cost. Walk, bicycle, or take public transit whenever possible.
This is a great start, everyone! Let's spread the word to all the young people in our countries that if we all work together in exchanging ideas, we can offer a global vision that will ensure our world will be a better place for generations.
Yes, because by working together and exchanging ideas,
the youth of today's world can make a difference
and make our world a better place to live. Thank you.
Navigating your life to a new world. 计时开始。
That's it for today.
I'm exhausted.
Hey guys, wanna grab some pizza and some beers?
Why not? We can have dinner together.
Hey Joe, you look pissed. What's up?
Oh, Lily and I are in the same group for the presentation next week.
Think I'm happy being partners with my brother?
What's the topic of your presentation?
Analyzing the current industrial structure of Southeast Asia.
No way! Your topic sounds terrible! I bet you guys don't do well.
Come on, never underestimate me.
I'll be fine, Sajo. Trust me. Stanley, what are you doing?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm applying for a foreign exchange program next year. Why? Interested?
Depends which university you are applying to.
Have you heard of Baghdad University in Iraq?
I think Baghdad, Iraq? Are you serious?
You're serious. Stanley and I are applying for a 6-month exchange program at Baghdad University.
Come on, you want to get yourself killed? Iraq is a war zone.
You guys are crazy. Iraq? ISIS is everywhere.
It's a stereotype that there is terrorism everywhere. But yeah, ISIS is a real threat.
Iraq is a country rich in history.
Our history teacher even talked about an ancient civilization in modern-day Iraq.
It's worth taking a risk. Nothing venture, nothing gain. Of course, we'll need to be well prepared.
Oh, who knows? Maybe we'll even survive.
I'm in. Iraq sounds awesome.
And the best thing is that the exchange student program at BadAU is totally free.
Free? Did someone say free? Count me in, studying in Iraq. Makes sense to all of us.
Yeah, I am coming.
Oh, Mom, Dad, we're gonna miss you.
Oh, kids, we're going to miss you too.
Back day, huh? You guys sure you really wanna do this?
I still think you two are insane. Iraq, war, turns to ISIS.
Relax, Mom.
Relax, we'll be fine.
Don't worry.
Your mom is worried. I'm worried too. There's always stuff on the news about Iraq.
We watch the news too, but at first, we weren't even thinking of going to Iraq.
So then why Iraq?
We knew we could reduce the risk by being well prepared.
So how have you prepared yourselves?
We've gone online and found out everything we can about the political and security situation in Iraq.
We also found out about the business opportunities in Iraq.
What are you talking about, Joe? Business opportunities?
What are you going to do? Sell body bags? Sell coffins?
Come on, Mom. Get real. We'll be learning about doing business in Iraq.
Iraq suffered through decades of wars. The people need everything.
No doubt. You are bang on about that.
Will you learn anything about Iraqi culture?
Mom, Iraq is the location of the Mesopotamia civilization, one of the world's first. The whole country is like a living museum.
Joe and I can learn about an ancient civilization while experiencing modern-day Iraqi culture.
The more I hear about this, the more I like it. Doing a business exchange program at BetterU does sound like a good idea, honey.
Oh, just make sure you FaceTime every night and Joe, please remember to change your underwear every day.
And Mom, come on.
Busted. Don't worry, Mom.
So I guess you're going to Iraq. What do you need?
Everything. Great. Let's go shopping.
It's only been 3 days, but I love Iraq.
It's only been 3 days, and you look like an Iraqi.
I feel like an Iraqi.
I'm feeling pretty local too.
You both look great.
Dinner was delicious. What was that we had again?
Maskouf is the national dish of Iraq.
That was the best fish I've ever had. Dessert was awesome too.
Yeah, the baklava was so good.
What is that you're wearing, Lily? It looks really good.
Thanks, Sally. It's called a juba.
Yeah, Lily and I picked these out at a market. What are you guys wearing?
Dish dashas. Traditional Iraqi clothing. We got these from the main mosque.
What was the mosque?
The mosque was so beautiful and so huge.
And the call to prayer.
Cool. Was the market busy?
Oh, yeah. The market was there.
But what?
We had lots of people coming up to us and wanted to buy stuff.
Wanting to buy stuff? What?
Young lady were asking us where we got our makeup from. And everyone wanted to see our cell phones and asked us if we would sell them.
No way, both of our cell phones are really old.
I can't believe that anyone want that.
I'm telling you, Iraq is a huge business opportunity.
There's much that people need and want to buy.
Hello.
All right, Tarzan.
Let's go. I need a coffee.
Bob.
Thank you.
The 31st 对表演题目是 Race Without Borders. 计时开始.
Oh my gosh! What's over there? It looks so good.
That's the famous bubble tea, which contains milk, black tea and tapioca. You must taste it before you return to Poland.
Sure.
Hey!
What are you doing? Your stove has crossed the line.
What? What line? I don't see any.
Here's the line.
You've gone way too far beyond the line.
Oh, you're so stingy. Judging from your accent, you must come from mainland China.
Yes. My father came from China in 1949 to protect Taiwan. What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with me? You're a loser coming from China. You don't even belong here. Get out of my homeland.
What? Is Taiwan yours? I'm
You are a rude tycoon!
What did you just say?
What are they talking about?
They're arguing about the space of their stalls in the night market.
What about tycoon and people from China? What do they stand for?
Well, it's because of the history of Taiwan. Tycoon is originally used when mainlanders in Taiwan held certain discrimination against native Taiwanese.
Oh, I see. Taiwan is a small island with a rich history.
To be honest, sometimes I don't know who I am.
What do you mean?
My mother is a native Taiwanese. My father, on the other hand, is the second generation of the mainlander. I really don't understand why mainlanders and native Taiwanese still hate each other after so many years living together.
Well, try to erase your family's identities. For me, you were and still are Taiwanese.
Thanks. So, what about you? I knew that Germany and Russia took turns invading Poland during World War II because of the geographical location. Did that affect you?
Yep, it did. Actually, it affected my whole family. My grandmother's family was killed by German Nazi. They were Jews in Poland.
And I have a bit Russian in my blood.
Luckily, she met my grandfather. He was a German soldier.
Although I'm a German, I don't support Nazism.
They got married after the war and decided to stay in Poland. I know in the past, German Nazi killed 6 million Jewish people. However, it's our history. We cannot change it. The truth is that German Jews are my grandparents and I have a lovely family. But my friends kept on making fun of my identities.
Then, how did you make it? How did you put hatred aside and truly love your country, your family, and yourself?
Last year, I volunteered at a nursing home in Russia, checking kids' health. Suddenly, I realized that it's not necessary to have bias towards identities. We may have different pasts, but the future is what we can work on. We are the citizens of the world. We need to use love and no hatred to make this world a better place.
Oh, thank you for inspiring me.
It's my pleasure.
From now on, I will try my best to embrace my identities and pay it forward.
Yes,
only with love and understanding can we move on instead of hating each other.
I'm so glad that I can have a good impact on you.
You again?
Calm down. I just want to apologize. I was way too emotional, so I said what I shouldn't said. And I can't see anything in this pair of sunglasses. That's why I crossed the line.
Okay, apologies accepted. These are a new pair of sunglasses. I think you can have them.
Oh, that's so sweet of you. It's so cute. And you can have my pair of slippers.
Ugh,
they aren't that bad. Come on.
No!
I thought we were friends already. Hey, where did you go?
Through youth exchanges, we build global vision and now we understand that race is without borders. Thank you.
第32队表演题目是 Unity Makes the Hope， 计时开始。
One, two, three.
Hello, everyone. We are Hope.
I'm Harvey.
I'm Olivia.
I'm Patrick.
I'm Alan.
Finally, protest castings are over.
Yeah, it is extremely boring for me to have my whole day spent on listening to the environmental education classes.
I'm guessing that you're supposed to have no interest in that class, is that right?
Oh, come on. You know, I really heard about all things about environmental issues. I think that is none of my business.
Carmen Jerry and Jenny through the International Volunteer Service. We will be happy to have you.
Let me see what's special. Taiwan's heart of Africa? I had never learned about that.
And Swaziland Volunteering Service? Oh, is there something interesting in this flyer?
Ha ha ha! You're paid for what you said.
Who are you?
Who am I? It's not important. Right now, listen carefully. I won't say it again. You're gonna test to know what they do. What the hope is, let's play a game. Hello, move!
What happened to us?
I have got no idea about this data. Where is here?
And who am I?
Welcome to Africa.
Who are you?
Who are you?
We are new volunteers of Heart for Africa from Taiwan. I'm Patrick, and this is Alan.
It's ridiculous, you mean I'm in Africa?
This is Swaziland, located surrounded by Republic of South Africa. It's also one of our international allies. You guys are support and send rescue teams too.
We were a stunning group of the population in Africa. They have been lots of poor children living in poverty. We not only particularly look after them, but also assist the local farmers to solve problems with the crops here.
We are here for the improvement of local living conditions. Hope is our creed. However, each of the letters in hope symbolizes a different meaning respectively.
Wait a second. Is any hope to get back home?
Hope is the symbol of
hunger,
orphan,
property,
and education. These are primary objectives of our service. With the spirit of hope, we are given power to have everything done.
By the way, we also teach the locals here to cultivate crops, sow crops, sing, dance, and float on the water.
What's more, we had even constructed a reservoir through fun before. The purpose of all these are to pursue for the better lives of the locals.
Wow, that was simply brilliant of you guys. I'm wondering if it is possible to help you out. Don't ever underestimate me. I have been always doing all the housework in my past.
Don't ever buy into his work. He is probably pretending the chops and turns his mommy demanding. To be honest, he's a guy with no patience.
Okay, let's move on. Right now, we're preparing to teach Chinese to children. They will get an exhausting afternoon. Hurry up!
Hurry!
Let's go! That's such a powerful word with energy and patience. I'm getting tired.
Me too. I was following up Patrick to help him assist a local to the cultivate crops. And then we successfully mailed a filter.
We've taken advantage of this modern filter. The locals are more capable of consuming clean water.
I have done a great job too. I was going after a local woman and doing the closest with them while passing by a region. I even spotted lots of campers, which are campers and millennial teams.
With so many things done today, we'll therefore get an
Yes. And let's end this conversation. Shall we take a nap first? I simply feel like dying if I will try to work another hour.
Hello, Mora, ha!
Olivia, look!
What?
We are back home. Hold up. Am I dreaming or something really happened to us?
I only remember the witch cursed spell and we have been to Africa and now we're back again.
Carmen Jeria Juni through the International Volunteer Service. We will be happy to have you.
I think you won't get us again. You had got a wonderful trip before.
Taiwan's heart for Africa. Hope? Yeah, we did it.
And we also can do that at any time, is that right?
Sure, then I have to go.
Why?
We want to learn more about it.
When you need me but do not want me, then I must stay. When you want me but no longer need me, then I have to leave.
Bye.
See you.
Olivia, I have to say, we're doing a wonderful trip, haven't we?
You can say that again. We're covering something we have never done before.
Now, we promise we will do our best to make the world a better place.
I hope so. 1, 2, 3. Thanks, everyone.
The 33 表演题目是Learn from people on the road. 计时开始。
Sania is a Taiwanese YouTuber who has her own channel on YouTube.
Hello, YouTubers. I'm Sania from the show From Taiwan to the Road. Today, I'm gonna to interview some exchange students to know what they think of Taiwan. If you like my channel, remember to subscribe it and follow me. All right, here comes our foreign friend.
jaw.
Jen?
Abagaba.
And Gina?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Sharing you with your opinion and experience about your life in Taiwan. First question, tell us about some ignorance you feel about Taiwan. Start from Gina.
Hi, I'm Gina. I am American. It's interesting that when I told everyone I'm gonna go to Taiwan, they all thought I will go to Thailand. Even my father also asked me, when will you go to Thailand? Until I corrected him several times.
Are you kidding me? It's still happening 21st century?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
And what's your story, Jen?
Another thing I want to mention is that people here don't eat dogs.
Dogs?
And a cat either.
It seems that it is a strong prejudice against Asians.
Of course, we're just like others, love
different.
In my country, they all think Asian can speak English. However, when I come here, I think they are just too shy to speak.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that I'm speaking English right now. Okay, next question. What are the things that impress you the most here?
People, definitely. My host family and my classmates are super friendly, heartwarming, and respectful. They are so open to foreigners.
Totally agree. My classmates must think I am some kind of movie star. They just keep asking me to take selfies with them all the time. Come here. Say cheese.
Cheese.
And they tell me to see many tourist spots, such as Taipei 11 and so many temples that I can't even remember the name.
They probably sing your Beyonce Caucasian version.
What's it gonna be, boys?
I watch you, you watch me.
What's it gonna be, boys?
Can you hear the famous tree?
What's it gonna be, boys?
It's not including we should leave. Okay, besides that, I want to talk about food. Food in Taiwan is just like the fusion of different culture. Can you imagine that I can have a crepe with Chinese cuisine? It's so creative!
Yes, Taiwan's the island of cuisine and nice people for sure.
Except for that, what are the things that you can't tolerate?
Come on! I want to talk food more about chicken fillets!
Wait.
Okay. Well. I think the traffic here is so unbelievable. I mean that it's often to see the riders break the law like driving in the opposite way or running in the red lights.
And the pedestrians are poor here. We are forced to walk right in the middle of the street time after time because there is no sidewalk or it's probably too many bikes to walk.
It's impossible to imagine that before I came here.
It's true. Lots of foreign friends complain to me about this problem.
Aside from that, Taiwan is a great place for living.
Yes, great food, people,
and you!
All right, last question. What have you got after this journey in Taiwan?
Friendship, I think. I shall miss all these friends who help me, care about me, even we just met. Love you, all of you.
And Gina? I have learned some Chinese and cultural difference, like Li He, Jia Ba Wei, and I will use this Taiwanese greeting more often after back to my country. It's so cute.
Thank you. Maybe we can dine together.
Hey, kill me. Besides those, I think I get to know myself better after experiencing the scene in another country. It's just like being in another planet where you eat the food you never try and speak the language you don't know. It really helps me to grow myself.
Okay, thanks for all the guests here. Hope you can get a clearer picture about Taiwan on the perspective of these foreign friends. Stay tuned on my channel, From Taiwan to the World. See you!
Bye-bye!
第三十四对表演题目是 To experience is to believe. 计时开始。
Oh, pass please. It's Jack's report card. Let me see. Chinese A, Math A, nice job. And English D, Jack, come here, now. Oh God, is that my report card? I'm done.You almost got straight A for all the subjects, but for your English, it's always D. This is not my fault because our English teacher just read a textbook and never explained it. Don't just blame on your teacher, Jack. Porque su inglés siempre está malo. Okay, this is our test today. Do you understand it? What are you talking about? French or Japanese? No, it's Spanish. This is the way I learn English in my school. Well,It's really a problem. So, how do you wish to solve the problem?
Like a study abroad or...
Okay, as you wish. If you can promise, you can improve your English, then choose a country.
Oh, seriously? Even Mexico? I'm so interested in the hot desert and the deadly drug dealer.
All right, weird kid. Just learn your English as well as you can.
I love you, Dad!
A few days later, the last day he go to school.
Hey, what's up? You know what? I'm going abroad next week.
Wow, that's really cool. Where will you go?
I will go to Mexico.
What? Mexico? You want to be a Mexican drug dealer?
Come on, don't you think that being in the trees is really cool?
Yes,
but... Just imagine that, people with guns surrounding you. It's so exciting, right?
Yes, but I saw news about Mexico yesterday. The man was walking in the street and the mafia gave him a gunshot. Oh my God!
Wow, I think that won't happen to me. It happened to me. I've learned taekwondo. Maybe I can fight with him.
All right, good luck for you.Remember to bring a sombrero to me, okay?
Yeah, well.
Oh, and come back with a whole body.
Damn you. You don't even have to worry about me to lose Emma. You come back.
When Jack arrived in Mexican airport.
Hola, excuse me, how are you doing?
Well, just a little bit cold. It's not really summer, what I feel like in winter.
Well, it's not so cold.The weather even gets snowy in winter.
I just found there are so many white people around here, and nobody with a gun on their hand or sombreros on your head. It's quite weird.
Oh, I think you have some misunderstanding. Actually, the drug dealer, the sombrero, or men playing guitar everywhere, etc. They only appear in the movie. The only thing real is there are so many deserts.
But how can it be?
It's for the history. Mexico has been ruled by Spanish, so there are lots of Spanish people here. The people you see are their offspring.
Oh, how embarrassing. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Many people have this kind of myth. Tell your friend you are not like that in the movie.
Of course, I will. I promise.
It's been a long time come back to Taiwan.His parents are happy for his back. His friends also make a welcome party for him.
Surprise!
Welcome to Taiwan! You guys, it's the sombreros for you.
Oh, thank you. I miss you so much, bro. You really come back with a whole body.
Look, it's his hand.
It's me.
How about your stay in Mexico?
Well, it was very nice.It's very different from what I've saw. They are passionate, they are hospitable, and the girls are really sexy.
Oh!
That's me, okay. I wanted to immigrate to Mexico.
So, you mean we were wrong, right? It's really amazing that Mexico is such a nice country.
Yes, we can't just observe the information from the movies. We have to go out to see the world.
To see is to believe.
We can't just stay in our lives. Next time, we have to go there and see what the world is like.
Thank you.
第三十五队表演题目是 Expanding the Vision, Embracing the World. 计时开始。
Indonesia has cold flu.
Of course they do. But Nancy, we want to learn about a new culture instead of find the best there.
But there are many handsome guys in England.
And Andrew from terrorist attacks in Indonesia.
Well, our goal is to be good ambassadors and bring back useful knowledge and cultural experiences.
Oh, come on.
Languages and customs. But the most important important thing we realized is to embrace people of different regions and beliefs with an open mind.
With an open mind, we all love to expand our region and embrace the world. Thank you.
各位同学，还有各位老师，还有我们评审同仁，还有工作人员，大家好。这个，同学哦，为了这次的比赛，可能应该是准备了很久的时间，而且事实上也花了很多的时间跟努力，哦，尤其是你们的老师啊，陪着你们，承受很大的压力，哦，但是，这种比赛总是有分数的高低啊，我们希望同学呢，不要把分数，啊。不管你有没有晋级啊，都不要啊太放在心上哦，因为只要有学习到上就好了哦，所以我想说你们啊放轻松啊，好，但是我们还是要给各位同学一些意见哦啊，让大家能够彼此互相学习啊，好，我讲一些我的看法哈，就说我们的哦这个表演节目。表演的活动要贴近我们的主题，像我们的主题是什么 ？Global Vision， 是不是 ？Youth Exchange， Youth Exchanges， 是不是？所以你的主题要贴近这个我们的主题。然后我发现到有一些人声音稍微小了一点点，这个有可能是你个人的因素，但是也有可能你在讲的时候都在后面，所以有时候我们在讲的时候。你要尽量的面对的台，面对的这个观众，这样的话你声音会传得比较大声一点点，然后每一组难免会有一些差异，有一些组是相当的平均，有一些组它的有一些差异是比较大一点点，比方说有可能有一些人的程度特别好，有些人程度稍微弱一点点，然后我们在表演的时候，我们每个episodes 它都要连接的很顺很紧凑不要花太多时间在一个 episode 一个 episode， 不要说花太多时间在连接上然后不要让人家感觉到很 rush， 我发现到之后这一次可能是因为只有五分钟然后你要把那么多的 message 那么多 information 凑在一起有一些人会觉得很赶，所以感觉到有不少组我觉得说他感觉到蛮冲突的他在讲话里面是有点冲突，动作是有点冲突，我们的动作是要把它完成要把它完成，还有就是说我们的台词我们的 lines 你是要把它演出来的，不是说只要把它讲出来就好，我想这个是非常的重要，所以各位同学要去揣摩你的角色然后用看你的角色要去揣摩它，然后用这个角色适当的态度和感情把它演出来不是话讲出来就好了，要把它演出来，而且很自然的很适当的演出来然后然后你要想到就是说我们在做这个表演的时候，你要想到怎么样来吸引观众的 attention， 观众的兴趣就是说说教性不要太重说教性不要太重那基本上呢各位同学的表演呢英语的口语基本上都还算蛮顺畅的除了有一两组以外没有，基本上都是蛮顺畅的那我们在英语的 oral delivery 方面呢要不要太 monotonous 不要太平就是说要我们在讲英语的时候是要有点抑扬顿挫的好，就是说你们在表达情感方面，在表达态度方面，要特别的注意，就是这个角色要特别的注意。那偶尔会有一两组，他忘了部分的台词，你要知道你忘了台词以后你要怎么处理。有一些组处理得非常的好，好，那就是这样。希望各位同学有一些收获。好，我们现在呢，给老师鼓掌一下。好，现在给你们自己鼓掌一下。大家都非常的辛苦。 哦，好，不要把成败得失放在心上，哈、哦，好，谢谢。
谢谢教授，接着请杨义军教授上台讲评。
在场的各位同学，还有我们评审同仁，还有工作人员，大家好。今天大家很辛苦哈，在这边待了一天，然后看了每个学校的表演。那刚刚其实很多重点陈老师都已经提了，那我大概再补充几点啊。第一个就是其实像刚刚有几组同学，他们有用到不同的英语国家的角色。当你在诠释这些不同的 native speaking country 的那个 people 的那个 accents， 你应该有差别才对。比如说美国人的英文其实跟英国人的英文是不太一样的，所以这部分你可以去注意一下哈。那比如说日本人讲英文会有那个 的音发不出来的部分，你也可以去揣摩一下。所以在这角色的揣摩上，我想大家可以再更注意一下。那我想提一下，刚有一组那个做那个 French kid， 那个不是，对不起，那个就是他们那个法国人，他们在打招呼的时候不是用 cheek 那个吗？去 kiss 吗？不是用嘴巴亲哦，他是用那个脸颊去亲脸颊哈、哦，而且亲的那个程度是有差的哈、哦，所以你在这个部分你可以再更去注意一下哈、哦。那接下来的话，我们觉得比较好嘛、表现比较好的那个组别。重点是他有把一些时事的东西 combine 进来，在他们的这个演出里面哈。那因为这次的主题是 exchange 嘛哈 ，global vision， 还有那个 youth exchange 嘛。那所以这个跨文化的这个交通沟通，怎么样来跨文化的沟通，基本上你可以去从这边去琢磨。那评审老师他会希望从你的表演当中看到一些很让他惊喜的元素，哈，像刚刚有一组那个爸爸很有钱，就打开那个西装里面都是那个假钱，我觉得这个就是个很好的 surprise， 哈，让大家觉得哎、这个角色很有一个特色这样子。那接下来就是中间的那个换场时间，我会建议不要太久。有些组他中间在换服装的时候，真的花太多时间了哈。再来，我会建议大家，你们在演出的时候要尽量往前走。再来，你前面的铺陈不要太长，你的这个主题重点是什么，你要尽快的把它表现出来。因为第一个，你的时间是有限的，哈。那有某几组他前面拉太长，所以他重点到后面可能到第三分钟才表现出来，那有点太慢了。好，所以你前面的铺陈不要太长。再来，你的 topic、你的 title 跟你的演出要符合。我们发现有几组，他可能他的 title 跟他演出的内容事实上是不太符合的。那这个事实上相对也会扣到一点分数。那不过还是觉得大家的表现都非常的好，那很辛苦大家，谢谢，谢谢。
那各位大家都很紧张哈。我们希望赶快来公布我们今天的结果。我们是照各队的这个序号来宣布。好，入围的队伍有序号二号。好。第二队友是三号。第三队是九号，第四队是十号。终于有听到一个欢呼声了啊！好，第五队是十一号。还有，再来是，十三号，第七队是 14号。第八队是17号。第九队是18号。很好啊，终于有欢呼声。好，第十队是21号。第11队23号。好，第12队是26号。第13队是28号。好，很好。
后面几乎都有。
第14队29号。哦，是是。好，继续努力。好。第15队30号。第16队是31号。第17队是32号。第18队34号。还有我们有一队19队是35号。好，恭喜我们19队哈。
讲题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Since Taiwan is an island surrounded by the sea, we were hardly in contact with Western people in the past, but everything has changed. Now we live in a global village. The gap has vanished.As long as we make the most of online resources, we can break the limits of space and time to conduct diplomacy more effectively and efficiently. As to how to build friendly and everlasting relationships with other countries, there are some practices. Youth diplomacy provides young citizens with the knowledge and skills needed to both.Understand and act on the globalized world, and offers its members the possibility to assist to conferences, debates, workshops, study trips, and so on. Now, Yuki is going to elaborate on one of the ways of using the internet for youth diplomacy.
Thank you, Penny.The methods of using networking resources for youth diplomacy are as follows. First of all, we can create a social group on Facebook, post the videos or articles to introduce Taiwanese culture, or upload the interesting videos about Taiwanese customs and traditions to YouTube as a way to make foreigners understand more about Taiwan.For example, I have some friends living overseas. By capturing their experiences and sharing, like when they had a gourmet weekend, I could upload and share that information with others, and vice versa. My foreign friends say that they find it interesting to see what I do on Facebook, because Taiwanese culture is different and novel to them.These media channels open more doors for youth around the world to interact and communicate with one another. Next, Sunny is going to tell us more about other useful online resources.
Thank you, Yuki. I think youth diplomatic experiences are often published on social networking sites and web blogs.The internet is a very useful platform for exchange of information. With online resources, participants in youth diplomacy can keep in touch via emails or social networking sites, such as Twitter, as opposed to letters. Online platforms really help a lot in maintaining relationships. In addition, the messages of youth diplomatic activities held by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, applications of exchange students, international student reception, and so on, are usually pressed on the relevant websites. Getting these messages from newspapers is much slower. On the contrary, online resources are abundant and immediate, making young people have more access to international affairs. And last, Lisa is going to wrap up the introduction with some relevant online organizations.
Thank you, Sunny. Indeed, more and more international youth organizations are made up of outstanding young leaders from around the world. They may have meetings, discuss global issues, and involve themselves in international affairs via online platforms. Since the internet has no borders, young leaders make their voices heard online in every part of the world. Despite the convenience of online resources, we should learn to distinguish what ideology online arguments are based on. If we develop the ability of critical thinking, not being influenced by the media, we can be aware of current affairs, maintain our own ideas and arguments, and further be a part of youth diplomacy.
Thank you.
演讲题目是 Number 5, 计时开始。
Good morning, honorable judges, teachers, and fellow students. Today, our topic is the opportunities and challenges of globalization. It has been a long time that adventures is in our genes. Since the first man set out from Africa to all over the world, the adventure of people have never been stopped. Even if we have printed our footprints to all over the world, the adventure still not go to the end. And for students like us, one of the powerful weapons to go adventure is the language. Just like English, Indonesian, and Japanese. Of course, not only learn the English or the Japanese in Taiwan, we have to go out and see the world.
Yeah, like me, I have been to Australia. I think because of globalization, we have the powerful competitive. How to say it? I have been a international meeting. I think it's a good idea. We can use the electronic advice and to do the meeting. And I think Australia in this area they have so many people from any country, not only locals. The people from Korea, Japan, and Taiwan, they have go to Australia to stay competition and to make us language skill more proof.
If you are not smart and also not enough money, we can attend exchange student that's held by school. Be a certain exchange student. Of course, we need to pass the simple test. even though 10 days is not too long, but we can practice our English and learn a lot of things textbook didn't say, such as international viewpoint, different culture. I went to Indonesia last year. I noticed that they are not poor and their economy has been advanced repeatedly. And their students also interact with many countries. And they even want to go abroad study. So if I stay in Taiwan, I will never know these things.
Okay. Well, last year I went to Mexico as an exchange student. We exchange student get together. We're not talking about the movies or video games. What we talk about? We talk about the countries. We have to introduce our country to everyone. They have people from all over the world, such as United States, America, or Germany, even Slovakia. So I noticed that when after my introduction, they even don't know where Taiwan is. So that's a problem in our nation. So I think we could we can learn English as well as we can. And if we got a chance, we can have a student to abroad. And I think use this small power and we can change the world. We keep going, change, and just like our ancestor, they haven't stopped, and we will never stop. Thank you.
Number 1, 计时开始.
Dear judges, here we're going to show the topic. It is International Youth Exchange. As far as we know, I think we can start with the basic establishment of youth exchange clubs on Facebook in order to have more attention. From those who want to help us expand through the internet with Facebook, we can have everything done very easily.
Facebook is an app in social media, and we can use it to promote activity like donuts, shoes, clothes, and so on. And we can use it to help pro children. And YouTube is a platform, and it provides a lot of videos, and we can use it to learn a lot of information from it. For example,
another app is famous for teenagers. Twitter is a famous app for teenagers. We can use it to post how's going in the world. Many celebrities promotes the charity and politicians for everyone. If one like can get $1, they may be a rich man. And people can also write on signature and in prison word to encourage people and posting the beautiful and joyful picture to show your friend you where you go and what you do. And it is there is a thing that impressed me. My neighbor, my best friend Amy, he wanted to commit suicide because he got a bad grade in the school, and she felt sad every day. And she always tell him mom, he told his mom, there's a net pile in the net, and bullying hurt a lot, and she felt sad. But when she saw a favorite idol write an article, love yourself, and he will feel good, because he think her idol will impress me a lot. And we can also use this app to show your feeling and how you do. And we can use it to chat with a lot of foreign Nepal and know about foreign culture and things a lot.
Last but not least, Twitter is one of the most effective online channel for the promotion. With this social platform, we can globally share and spread the information with Twitter's user, which is surely a way to raise the concept. As for local or private channels, I would say the International Liar and Ciji Association are the organization we normally join. In conclusion, we are the world citizens, and we are ready to start serve the world. And that is the best way we think to the youth exchange with the internet. Thank for everyone.
演讲题目是 Number Three， 计时开始。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Taiwan enjoys close economic, social, and cultural relations with countries in Southeast Asia, and is home to many laborers and immigrants from the region. However, we should consider and ask ourselves this question.Do the laborers and immigrants living in Taiwan, do they feel Taiwan their second home? Do we, Taiwanese people, treat it like our own, our family? According to statistics, by the end of July 2016, the number of migrant workers had increased over 600. To make a living, most of them do the jobs that Taiwanese people would not want to do, which are so-called 3K works, meaning dirty, dangerous, and hard labors. These include works such as constructing the bridges by which we can go home, building the houses that we live in, or catching the fish we eat. As a result, hundreds of migrant workers are killed working in harsh conditions every year.
Besides these hard labors,There's also one kind of work that most Taiwanese would not prefer to do, which is taking care of our elderly, disabled family members. Today, we want to share with you an inspiring story from a senior student at our school. Jing Xuan was born disabled and needed to stay in a wheelchair all his life. During the past 3 years,A girl named Wati from Indonesia spent all her youth taking care of him. Following is the typical day of Wati, getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning and make breakfast for Jing Xuan. At 7, sending Jing Xuan to school. After arriving at school, Wati would massage Jing Xuan and help him do some easy exercises. During class time,Wati would help Jing Xuan take some notes, and at noon, she would feed him lunch. At 3 p.m., Wati would take Jing Xuan home and start to prepare dinner. At 5 p.m., Wati would help Jing Xuan take a bath, and then she had to clean the house. Not until Jing Xuan went to bed could Wati finish her day. Usually, Wati could only sleep 5 hours a day. This kind of busy day with 365 days a year for Wati. After Jingshan graduated from school this June, Wati also graduated from Taiwan. I would like to ask all the honored audience present today, who is willing to do this kind of exhausting and boring work, yet only get 22,000 NT dollars a month? Do we really treat Wati like her family and make Taiwan her home? Not only Jingshan, but also we owe a thanks to Wati. Thank you, Wati, and other thousands of Wati, for taking care of our family with your precious time. We would also like to thank foreign fishermen for catching fish for us. Do you know that the fish we eat every day are mostly caught by foreign fishermen? For the time being, 30,000 of foreign fishermen were employed by Taiwanese. Among them, 20,000 were employed outside of Taiwan and 10,000 inside. Those who are employed outside of Taiwan cannot go ashore unless they're sick and need to see a doctor. They got onto the boat in the tropical area where they don't need to wear winter clothes. But as they head further out to the cold sea, the clothes on them are usually not thick enough as the temperature drops. So our school started a campaign in December 2015 to raise winter clothes for foreign fishermen. During the 3 months, we've raised over 1,000 cartons of winter clothing for foreign fishermen in Nanfangao, Jilong, Kaohsiung, Penghu, etc. The fisheries agency in Kaohsiung even sent us an email to thank us and told us the clothes we sent was enough for all the foreign fishermen. From these two cases, we can see that the countries in Southeast Asia play a very important part in our country's economic, social, and cultural relations. And since Taiwan is a new home to many laborers and immigrants, we should treat them like our own.
Yes, they are our dear family. Thank you.
演讲题目是 Number 3, 计时开始。
Today, I'm going to talk about Southeast Asia. Before I get this topic, I don't really know anything about them. Luckily, 2 days after I got this topic, I found a job tutoring two Thai boys. I think this is a great opportunity for me to know something about them. So I went to the mom.I got a tea, some cookies when I got in, and she treated me so well. Later on, after 2 hours of tutoring, she kept me down, no, she kept me for dinner. After everything set, we started eating. She gave me so much food, like she kept putting things in my bowl. I'm thinking, wow, I just met her 2 hours ago.And she's treating me so well. My mom don't even do this to me. Yeah, I think it's a great part of their culture when they do this to the guests. I think a lot to the globalized language, English, to make me so, no, to help me know these good guys in Southeast Asia. Let's welcome Vivian.
We're living in a globalized world. In this world, bonds between people are getting tighter and humanitarian aid is becoming more and more important. Whenever there are disasters, such as earthquakes, tsunamis,typhoons or worse occurring in any countries, our hearts always go to those who are suffering. As a youth in As a youth in this global village, it goes without saying that it is our responsibility to help those in need. Even if their countries are far away from ours, however, a question comes out, how and what can we do to help those people? The first priority is to equip ourselves the ability in English. This is because the most of the news is written in English. When we have the ability to understand the news, we can easily get the messages from all over the world. Then we can start thinking about how and what can we do to help those people. Even we can do little to help them. We can also help spread the news in English online and let more people in different ways in different countries to know more about it. Let's welcome Lily.
When it comes to globalization, we need to know what it means first. In my opinion, globalization is mobilization. That is, globalization is having the ability to work and travel in different countries. Also, globalization creates opportunities for the youth to work and compete with other people internationally. However, it is also meant that our competitors are not only from Taiwan, but also from other countries. To survive this competitive world, English is the most important tool to help us achieve this goal. Why? That is because it's the common language used by people in the world. For example, last year I traveled to European countries. Even though I didn't know how to speak the language, I can easily ask for help from people who could only speak English on the street. Besides, I used to do a part-time job at a company. I found out that even though my boss could only speak English, it wasn't difficult for him to do business with Koreans, Japanese, or Indians. The main reason was that he could speak English. Therefore, the ability to speak English as a communication is an absolutely essential thing to be globalized. Last, let's welcome Stanley.
Thanks to the internet, the boundaries between people are becoming more invisible. There are lots of ways to conduct youth diplomacy online. For example,
thank you.
#1, 计时开始.
Good morning to everyone in attendance here. Recently in English class, our teacher explained that as young people, there are many ways in which we can play the role of young diplomats. As a teenager, my teacher had pen pals in many countries, and they would exchange long letters describing every aspect of their lives. He believes that if more young people try to conduct diplomacy in this manner, the chances of cultural misunderstandings would lessen, and the world would become a better place. This had a real impact on me. So I began thinking of how I could do something similar. I realized that conducting youth diplomacy in this day and age would be relatively easy due to the fact that our world is dominated by the internet and its copious amount of online resources. Now, Hank will continue with the second part of our speech.
Thank you, Angela. Our teachers experienced something really interesting to me. I too would love to have the opportunity to communicate with young people around the world. I worked together with my classmates to brainstorm, and we came up with the idea to create a Facebook group with the goal of increasing culture understanding between the youth of Taiwan and young citizens of other countries. We know that some groups such as the Academy of Youth Diplomacy already exist, but we feel we could make our group specific to Taiwan. We could share photos of our beautiful country, as well as information about life on this island, while providing articles about issues affecting young people here. International visitors to our page will also be able to leave comments and ask questions, thereby increasing communication between ourselves and other teenagers globally. Now, I would like to introduce Howard, who will continue with the third part of our speech.
Thank you, Hank. Facebook is certainly a good starting point, but we can also use YouTube as a method of conducting youth diplomacy. We could create our own YouTube channel and broadcast short videos about different aspects of life in Taiwan. For instance, we could show young people what a typical day is like at high school for teenagers in Taiwan, or educate them about other areas of life in Taiwan, such as our food, festivals, traditions, and rituals. We could even broadcast language lessons to give viewers the opportunity to learn Mandarin, Chinese, or Taiwanese, and conduct language exchanges so that we would also be able to strengthen our language skills. Through the use of these two social media sites, along with others that are available, the possibilities seem endless. Now, finally, Jessica will offer our concluding thoughts.
Thank you, Howard. I think both of these ideas are wonderful. We are really fortunate to be living in an age where international communication has been made easy. Therefore, we should take advantage of the amazing technology that is available to us in order to strengthen the relationships between ourselves and people of similar ages in other nations. Creating a Facebook page and establishing a YouTube channel may not seem particularly significant, but as the ancient Chinese writer Lao Tzu said, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. If the youth of other countries are encouraged to follow our lead, then interactions between different nationalities will gradually increase, and in the future, a greater understanding between nations will surely develop. Thank you for your attention.
Number 3,
if asked about our neighboring countries, the answers crossing my mind are China, Korea, or Japan. Somehow, I simply overlook Taiwan has a lot more next-door neighbors than the above. I believe the term Southeast Asia has been off many people's radars until the South China Sea dispute and our government's new Go South policy. On the other hand, although some people know this area, their instant impressions of it may be foreign laborers, foreign brides, caretakers, ladyboys, or poverty. Unfortunately, many of these impressions are stereotypes, or just a part of the big picture. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. allow us to introduce Southeast Asia. A more familiar name to most people may be ASEAN. Now, why don't you sit back and relax? My teammate will put together all the pieces and give you a bigger picture of the jigsaw puzzle.
Thank you, Zoe. ASEAN means the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. It is a 49-year-old organization that promotes regional cooperation and integration. All countries in Southeast Asia are members of ASEAN except for East Timor. With the third largest labor force in the world, it is one of the most dynamic economic regions. ASEAN has attracted investors of Taiwan and the world. In fact, Taiwan has an edge in effort to knock on its door. First of all, there is a close trade link between Taiwan and ASEAN. Among Taiwan's top 15 largest trading partners, six are from it. Besides, numerous migrant workers from Southeast Asia have played a part in Taiwan's economic growth. Moreover, about 200,000 immigrant brides from Southeast Asia call Taiwan home. Their second generation are not only the future of Taiwan, but also the pillars in expanding our influence in ASEAN.
How right, Shilinguas! We have a strong tie with Southeast Asia. In fact, after some research, I was surprised to find how similar Taiwan is to Southeast Asia. For one thing, we are both famous for our hospitality. You must be familiar with the joke about people mistaking Taiwan for Thailand. Besides being similar sounding, maybe that's because we both impress the world so much with our hospitality. For another, both areas have rich cultural elements because of unique geographical and historical backgrounds. Southeast Asia has a kaleidoscope of languages, religions, and cultures. At the crossroads of Europe and Asia, different cultures drifted in and out and left their footprints there. It's home to more than 40 ethnic groups, hundreds of languages, and almost any known religions. There, you may find people with a mosaic of faiths, Malay Muslims, Chinese Buddhists, Filipino Catholics, or Indian Hindus. You name it. Finally, Ellie will tell us more about our neighbors.
Thank you, Violet. Southeast Asia is famous for its diversity, and this diversity can also be seen in its prosperity. On the whole, Singapore and Brunei are developed countries which lie at one end of the spectrum. On the other end are Cambodia, Myanmar, and Laos. In the same way, political systems in Southeast Asia span a wide spectrum too, from democracies to one-party states and monarchies. However, this new frontier of groups is now without its problem. The culturally mixed environment is appealing to the world, but meanwhile, it's the root of ethnic and religious conflicts. Well, where will Southeast Asia go next, you may ask? Luckily, ASEAN provides a platform for all the powers to meet and solve problems. We all firmly believe Taiwan will not only see this economic engine stride forward under the roof of ASEAN. Taiwan will be there for it. Thank you.